John, John Lennon, why don't you stop by a minute? I've been trying to, you know, we've been so busy over the summer, and we've been, and I've been telling John that, you know, we wanted to interview you, you know, because you're a very special sheet metal worker. And I think right now is an opportunity that we have because we have such busy schedules. John Leonard has just recently graduated the Local 28 apprenticeship program. He's now a working journeyman in Local 28. But one of the things that we spoke about in Comet when we had our Comet class was some of the fears and some of the experiences that we've had as apprentices over the 4 years. And we were talking and we took a break, and then after the break John came back to me because he had said a couple of words, but he wanted to talk about something that was you know, something that was very important. So John, I just want to let you talk, you know, just revisit what we were talking about, you know, because obviously John is a very special sheet metal worker because he's got one arm and he's got a mechanical arm, but he does the job. So why don't we just talk about that, because this is something that I want people to know.
I had brought up to Ronaldo during our break that I wanted to speak again, and it was about the fact that I was accepted by my peers, that I worked as well, if not better than some, with what I had, and I would do well, they felt, in this trade, and it really made me feel wonderful to think of something like that, being that I'm a second generation sheet metal worker, my father was also a sheet metal worker. And it really was something I wanted to bring up to my other peers that were in that class.
And the fact that your disability, or if you we even want to call it a disability right now, I think it's more of a it's a challenge for you. That the point that we're really trying to make here is that this could really only happen in Local 28. And the reason is that if John were a non-union sheet metal worker or attempted to do sheet metal, believe me, John will not succeed in the non-union field because the non-union wouldn't hire you. They would not give him the opportunity. And because he came through the apprenticeship program in Local 28, the opportunity was there. He took advantage, and you lived up to the challenge. And whoever the critics were before, I guess they must be silenced now, because you really proved to, I guess, yourself and everybody else that you could
Absolutely.
Do it. So I think how we should leave it is Local 28 means opportunity for everybody.
Well, if you're willing to take the challenge and live up to it, yes.
And you'll succeed.
Yes, you will.
Well, the best of luck to you. Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you on the job.
Definitely.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now, that's very special. You know, really, it really could only happen in Local 28. Somebody with a disability like that, and I don't really even want to call it a disability, but you know, the fact that he could do the job with one arm says a lot for him. And you know, and I know when he first came into the union, a lot of other members didn't think he would succeed, but he really proved to everybody that he could, and really largely to the help of the members and the support of Local 28 School that he was able to succeed, and he has all the tools he needs to be a successful sheet metal worker.